Hey y'all, welcome to another WordPress Wednesday. My name is Corey Ashton here at WebTegrity in San Antonio, Texas. And this WordPress Wednesday, we are going to be talking about Div classes. So I understand that sometimes CSS can be a little bit intimidating, and especially to those that don't exactly understand how to write nerd code. So if you're trying to go in and make some changes to your WordPress website and you're kind of turned around on it and you really don't either understand what a Div class is, or maybe you understand it but want to figure out how to kind of write your own, play around with some of your own styling, I'm going to teach you how to do that. Really super simple, and I'm going to walk you through step by step so that you're not overwhelmed, all right? Before we get started, I need to give a shout out really quickly to our three awesome sponsors that cover our classes here in San Antonio and even online. So be sure to check us out over at webtegrity.com to learn more about our classes. But we love WP Engine. They're incredible hosting. I just had a client call me today and say she switched over to them, and it blew her mind at how amazing their support is, as well as their staging environment and backups and restoration for any errors that might happen on your website. Phenomenal, and you also have incredible speed. Then there's also WP Elevation. If you're a freelancer using WordPress, you need to check out their tracks. Incredible direction on how to grow your brand and your business. Then there's WP 101. If you like WordPress tutorials like you're watching right now, get ready to have your mind blown. Go check them out because they take video tutorials for WordPress to the next level. All right, here we go. You ready to learn some nerd code? I'm gonna shrink down so that y'all can kind of check this stuff out. All right, let's see. So I'm actually over in an environment that you can go to right now. I'll put the link in the description box below in case you can't check this out, but this is where you'd go. Watch this. So it's just codepen.io, okay? I'm gonna click enter. It's gonna ask me, are you sure you wanna leave? It comes here, and what I want you to do is just click new pen, all right? Up here at the top, click new pen. And they've got a couple of different layouts. Let's see if I can show you this. Slide up here. I can't show you. At the very, very bottom of the screen, they've got a few icons down here in the bottom corner of the screen, right down here, okay? You can choose your layout. This is the layout I like, and then we don't need JavaScript right now, so we're just going to stay here in HTML and CSS for the time being, okay? I want to teach you what a div class is. All right. You know how whenever you start your WordPress website, a lot of times it just says, hello world, right? And this is my text happening right over here. HTML, all HTML is text intermingled with a little bit of nerd code, which is the actual HTML, that gives it structure, all right? That's all it is. So I want you to think of a div class, and if you understand what I'm saying right now, it's this. Div, it's a div class. I want you to think of a div class as just a box. That's all it is. And it can be any shape you want. It's just a container. So whatever content you want inside that container, you can assign different styles to, different font size to, different color background. You can do whatever you want to inside of that container. All right, this is like a shipping container. We're gonna put everything inside of that box, right? And then on the outside of that box, we're gonna say whatever label we want to address. And that's how we know how to affect it inside the CSS. Are you following me? Watch this. Don't say no yet. You're following me. Here we go. Div, I'm going to give us a class, which is the label for it. That's all it is. You open quote and close it. We want to jump ahead right now, and at the end of this hello world, we want to close our box or close our div tag, okay? This basically says we're going to open the box here, we're going to put hello world inside of it, and we're going to close the box after it, okay? This is our div class. But now in order to make changes to the content sitting inside of here, we've got to give it a unique name, which is our class name, all right? And then that's how we address it inside of our CSS. So I'm just going to call this right here header title, all right? That's what we're going to call this, okay? And then I'm going to go, nothing should change here. Nothing should change yet. We need to go address things to hello world, we need to go give it some style, right? So we're gonna go into our CSS, which applies style, right? And we're gonna put a period that stands for class, and we have to do it verbatim. So header-title is how we open this, and then it closes, okay? So inside the header title, I'm gonna say that I want this hello world to be right dead center in the middle of my screen. So we're just gonna say text align center. Look at that. Look at this slide over right here. Slid over right there. And what if I wanted to say, I want my font size to be ginormous. Let's say font size colon, and I'm going to say 44 pixels. So nice and big. Whoa, look at that bounce out. That's pretty incredible. Let's even go even crazier and say background-color. We're going to give it some background color. You have to put a hashtag there, EA. And you can play around with all the different color codes. Look at that nice little gray that came in there. And let's give it some padding around it, right? Let's say padding, and let's give it some 40 pixel padding. So it's nice and big. Do you see how everything inside of this div class is being affected? What if I put something down below this div class? This is a sentence. And this would appear, look at this, this appears outside of my box that I built because it's outside of this div class. Do you see what I'm doing here? Outside of the div class sits my box, this is a sentence. And if I wanted this as a sentence, this little area right here, to do something else, to look different, I could assign a different box or a different divider, div class, right? That's all you're doing with div classes, okay? So how does that apply to WordPress? I'm gonna switch over to WebTegrity's website. And I want you to see that everything inside of our website is coded in a different div class. So this orange tag up here at the very top, this is all sitting in its own div class to tell it to have an orange background. And then it switches over to the menu and it says have a blue background here. So the way you find those things out, if you're trying to troubleshoot or figure out what your author may have called that div class so that you can overwrite it, right? We're thinking ahead. I actually browse with Firefox. I've trained with you guys before on some of our other videos. I use their add-on, their free add-on called Firebug. So I can come in here and it's basically an inspect element. That's all it is. I'm gonna go up here to this top line and I'm gonna see that this div class, look right here if you can, this div class is called top header container, okay? Top header container, and I'm gonna move out of the way here for a second because I want you to see that this says top header container in my style sheet. So this is our HTML side, this is our style sheet, our CSS file, and look at this. This little area right over here is our orange. So if we wanted to change that to our gray that we were just playing around with, we could say EA, EA, EA. And look at that, this top line up here just changed from orange to gray. That's how you go in and use the idea of div classes inside of your website. How cool is this, you guys? I have another video about the basics of CSS. And I will put the link in the, actually, I'm going to put the link just right here for you. So you can click on that and go, again, get another perspective of what CSS is, how it affects your website. But this was more trying to understand specifically what a div class does and is. I'm going to give you one more link that you're going to be able to play around with. It is over on W3 Schools, all right? So you can go over to W3 Schools. I'll give you a little link in the description box below that you can click on. I want you to come here and I want you to click on this green box right here that says try it yourself. Because when you do, it's going to open up a screen very similar to what we were just playing with over on CodePen. But I want you to see that the div classes that are assigned here are unique in some ways. You've probably seen this one before. The P means paragraph. That's actually, in a sense, a div class. It's just one of those that always exists. So it doesn't have to have the word div in front of it, right? The word body is another one. This says the entire body of our website. It has an open and a close, just like the paragraph has an open paragraph here and a close paragraph. In a sense, these are kind of like div classes. You've probably seen them also with the H3 or H1, the header tags, right? We're putting it kind of in bookends or in the open box and we close the box, all right? Same concept completely with using a div class here. And you can play around with some of these things, see the results immediately right over here. How cool is this, you guys? I hope you're nerding out with me and that you're understanding a little bit more about div classes and CSS inside of your WordPress website. If you do make changes to any of your style sheets, you can always go to your custom CSS box inside of your WordPress website and drop in all of your changes here, and that completely overwrites whatever your author did. And it's safe whenever you're doing updates, right? You don't need a child theme if you're using some sort of a custom CSS box to do edits. I hope you're having a great day. Be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel over here in the corner. Click that little play button and subscribe to our channel so that you're checking us out every single WordPress Wednesday here on YouTube. We're giving you all sorts of great goodies for WordPress. Hope you're having a great one. Catch you next week. Bye-bye, y'all.